It was always the holy grail. We're going to be filming outside of the International Space Station, putting the camera on the robotic arm of the space station to film shots of the Earth, establishing shots of the International Space Station, and a spacewalk in 3D 360 cinematic VR. We really wished that the entire spacewalk filming day would be flawless so that we could capture everything. Because you don't really have a second opportunity to do something like that. We were all there in our sort of mini mission control here in Canada, in Saint-Hubert, at the Canadian Space Agency. We were all watching the camera coming out of the Japanese experimental module, and we were all very excited because it was out for the first time ever, and we were just about to begin our operations. And so the moment that Canada arm came in, connected to the camera, powered it on, all the lights on the little panels started to flash red. And the engineers had prepared for all possible scenarios. But the one that nobody had really planned for was a panel flashing red, which meant mistake of unknown origin. And so that's what happened. Nobody knew what was going on. It was just not working.
So when the camera didn't turn on, we're like, okay, what's ahead of us? What are our options? So definitely you always think about, okay guys, we've been in production in space for 3 years. We've filmed unique, incredible stories from astronauts from inside the space station. Maybe that's the end of the road and that's how we tell the story. But honestly for us, not filming outside the space station wasn't really an option.
And so we started conversations internally, conversations with NASA engineers to try to figure out what could have possibly gone wrong. We singled out what the problem actually was. And there was an issue on a specific device that would bring the electric power from Canada Arm and sort of convert it for the camera system itself. That whole process before we could find A, the solution, and B, the next perfect timing to actually deploy in space and film spacewalk, that was almost a year.
Not every production is going to be filming in VR on the ISS, but you're going to come across challenging problems. For instance, for mission to the moon, we've often had to work in very difficult environments to capture this story of this new era of spatial exploration through the trainings that they do on Earth. So, you know, those environments, they're very hostile sometimes and they're not optimal for filming.
So part of Mission to the Moon series, we documented different NASA training operations. One of them was happening in Iceland because they use the terrain as a replica of the moon terrain. Obviously, the biggest challenge of filming in 360 is you see everything. So where do you hide yourself? Where do you put your lights? Where do you ask your sound guy to be? So in Iceland, for example, we used to hide behind rocks or sometimes just going far in the distance to not be seen by the camera. So last summer, we went to Santa Catalina Island. It's an island at the coast of California. We went there to film another operation of NASA, but this time it was underwater. So basically, the astronauts will train themselves with the tools they might use in space, but underwater to have kind of sense of gravity. The last few years, we worked a lot with NASA people. With NASA people, you don't have a second take. They are really, you know, high-level professional people. So you have to be the same level as them. You have to be like an astronaut. You rehearse, you train, you test, and when it's the time of shoot, you perfect.
So the second time the camera came out of the International Space Station to do the filming operations, the spacewalk and all of the exterior shots in the vacuum of space, the camera followed the exact same path than the first time, and everybody is stressed out, so stressed out. But this time, the lights started to flash green, which meant that everything was fine. It was one of the most pressure relieving experience I've ever had in my life, where I felt like now it's going to work. We ended up filming for 6 days and we had no issue whatsoever, as if all the preparation, all the rehearsals, and I would argue almost that extra year that we had to sort of think again about what we were doing before we had our second chance, it seemed like suddenly all of that paid off and we had one of the most beautiful filming experience ever. The trick is getting the right people on board the adventure that will all rally around the idea that even though it's risky and new and that there's a strong potential that something doesn't work, that it's worth continuing, that it's worth materializing the full vision of this project.